फ्रेंड्स वेलकम टू अवर चैनल मैकेनिकल मोटिवेटर। टुडे वी गोइंग टू सी प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ लाइन इंक्लाइन टू बोथ द प्लेन्स। इनिशियली आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग द क्वेश्चन, देन आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग व्हाट आर द गिवन डेटास फ्रॉम द क्वेश्चन, देन आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग व्हाट आर थिंग्स वी नीड टू फाइंड, एंड आफ्टर दैट वी विल बी सीइंग हाउ टू ड्रॉ दिस डायग्राम स्टेप बाय स्टेप। वन एंड ऑफ द लाइन ए इज 30 mm अबव एचपी एंड 40 mm इन फ्रंट ऑफ वीपी। सो ए विल बी 30 mm अबव एचपी एंड 40 mm इन फ्रंट ऑफ वीपी। The other end of the line, that is B, will be 90 mm above HP and 110 mm in front of VP. So they have given the dimensions for the non-dimension. They have given the details for the line both points A and B. Next thing is they have clearly given that both the ends of the lines are lying in the same projectile. It means that A A dash and B B dash will be lying on the same line. So that's what I have written here. So totally we are having 5 ends. 4 ends directly we are given. 1 end is hidden. By using these 5 ends, we can draw the diagram. And finally, what we are going to find is we will be determining the theta, phi, alpha, beta, and front view length, top view length, true length. What is the length of the true length? And finally, we will be determining traces also. First step is we need to draw the reference line. The reference line is x, y. According to first angle projection, we will be drawing the vertical plane above and horizontal plane below. Now we will be going to the question. So given data, what they are given, A point will be 30 mm above HP and 40 mm in front of AP. From the reference line, take 30 mm and draw a straight line. So we have to mark A dash right, 30 mm above HP. For that, the distance between reference line and this line is 30 mm, and reference line and this line is 40 mm. So in this line, we can mark anywhere as A dash, and A dash and A should be lying on the same line. Next is point B. Point B is 90 mm above HP. So from the reference line, take 90 mm and draw a line. And this line is called as locus of B dash, and 110 mm in front of VP. So from the reference line, distance from reference line should be 110 mm. So for 110 mm, take a point and draw a straight line. And this line is called as the locus of B. We know very well that for marking the B and B dash, we have only one hint in the given data. That is, both the ends of the line are lying in the same projector. It means that A dash and B dash will be lying on same line, and A and B will be lying on same line, so that we can easily get the front view and top view. I have just rubbed this line because you can use your scale, right? So your first initially you place A dash right. You can also use a scale for marking A. See to it that A dash, B dash, A and B are lying on the same line. Since I am drawing in the board without any scale, so the line might be slightly inclined to the left or right. So when you draw the line, see to it that when you use your scale, and A dash, B dash, A and B, all the lines should lie on the same line. Initially we will be marking on A dash. With A dash, keep your scale and mark A, and then just follow whatever I steps repeated before. And you can use the values and you can mark the locus and then place the point B dash and B. A dash, B dash will be your front view, and A, B will be your top view. Take your compass, measure A dash, B dash and try to rotate an arc. If you rotate, means your rotating arc will be cutting locus of A dash at one point. That point is called as B2 dash. Mark that point and write as B2 dash. If its locus of A dash, means you need to extend this line vertically to the opposite locus. If its A dash, means you have to extend the locus of B. So from here, try to extend it to the opposite locus, that is locus of B, and you will be getting a point. This point is called as B2, and you have to put an arrowhead like this. The direction of arrowhead will be showing that the arc is moving downwards. Now just join AB2. So AB2 will be your true line, and AB is your top view. Now same procedure, measure AB. Take your compass, measure AB as your radius. Keep your compass at A and try to rotate an arc backwards. When you are rotating the arc will be cutting the locus of A at one point. That point is called as B1. Mark that point and name it as B1. Same procedure. If its locus of A, means you have to extend this line till the opposite locus, that is you have to extend till locus of B dash. Try to extend this line, from this point B1, try to extend this line vertically above till locus of B dash, and name that point as B1 dash. If it's B1, means B1 dash. If it's B2 dash, means it's B2. Now just to join A dash and B1 dash. So A dash and B1 dash is your true line. A dash, B dash will be a front view. Whatever length you are getting, that is, if whatever length you got for A, B, 2, same length only you will be getting for A dash and B, 1 dash. So, true length A dash, B, 1 dash equal to A, B, 2 will be same. Now, we are going to draw the traces. First step is, extend A dash, B dash. Extend your front view A dash, B dash till it meets the reference line at one point. Name that point as H. Then second step is extend your top view. So extend AB line to some distance till it meets the reference line at one point, and that point is called as V. Then you have to extend this point H, right? You have to extend this point H vertically downwards. When you are extending vertically downwards, this line will be meeting AB line at one point, and that point is called as your horizontal trace. Now, when you extend this point B, this point holds good for H and B, both it holds good. When you extend this point B vertically above, this line will be meeting your front view A dash B dash at one point. That point is called as your vertical trace. After completing all the diagram, then we will be going for the dimensioning. For dimensioning, if for example, if you take A dash, B dash, if your dimensioning means, the extension line should be very light and extension line should be drawn with your 2H pencil. This is dimensioning line. Dimensioning line should be parallel to whatever line you are dimensioning. If you are dimensioning for A dash, B dash, mean dimensioning line should be parallel to it, and try to break the line and write the number vertically with your HB pencil. Arrowhead should be sharp pointed one. And it should be drawn with your HB pencil. We need to dimension for front view, for top view, and true length. True length we are having above and below. You can dimension anywhere. So I have dimensioned the A, B, 2. So if you want to dimension, mean the extension line should be perpendicular to the A, B, 2, and dimension line should be parallel to it. Just break the line and write the number vertical. The line can be slanting, but the number should be vertical. And also you have to dimension for these things also. That is, initially we use these hints, right? So whatever hints we use, we need to dimension here. Just show the dimensioning. And after completing your diagram in your A3 sheet, the heading should be projection of lines. Its height of the text should be 10 mm. And whatever values you have determined. And most important thing is, we need to dimension the angle also. Just keep your protractor and measure and write whatever angle you are getting. For alpha we will be having 90, for theta it's 41, here beta is 90 and phi is 49. So theta, after completing it, try to put a box like thing and write all the values which you determine. Theta will be the true length inclination, alpha is the front view angle, phi is your true length inclination, beta will be your top view angle, and a dash b dash is your true length, sorry, front view, ab will be your top view, and a dash b1, b1 dash and ab2 will be your true length, and true length you will be getting like 84. So after completing, just cross verify with the answer, and at last you will write all dimensions are in mm, scale 1:1. These wording should be written in the right bottom corner. Height of text should be 5 mm. If you have any doubt, means you can write in the comment section, and if you feel this video is useful, means you can share with your first year friends, and do subscribe my channel Mechanical Motivator, then only you will be receiving all the videos which I upload. Thanks for watching this video.